I'm going to go over some tips to wire a GFCI. On the back of the GFCI, one side is going to say line, the other side is going to say load. Generally, the load side will have a piece of tape over the screws. On the line side, you're going to have a brass colored screw and a silver colored screw. And if you can't tell the colors, one side has a narrow slot, one side has a longer slot. The side with the narrow slot or the brass screw is the hot side. The longer slot or the silver screw is the neutral side. In your electrical box, if you only have two wires plus a ground wire, a bare ground or a green wire, or if you have two wires and no ground wire, you're only going to be using the line side. And that's the side without the tape generally, and you'll be using the hot wire, in this case, the black wire to the brass side or the narrow slot, and your white neutral wire to the silver screw or the wide slot. If you have four wires plus a ground or four wires with no ground wire, you're going to be using the line and the load side. For this, we're going to have to test to find which pair of wires are coming from the service panel. So we're going to be testing to find a hot wire. In this case, it's either going to be this black wire or this black wire. We're doing this project in the Chicago area, so we have metal boxes connected to metal conduit going all the way back to the service panel. So our conduit and the metal box is grounded. When I put the metal screw and the metal strap on the GFCI into this metal box, it's grounded all the way back to the service panel. If you're in an area with non-metallic cable, you're going to have a bare ground wire that you'll be connecting to the green ground screw. If you're in an area that uses non-metallic cable, your hot wire is going to be black or red. If you're in an area that uses conduit and the electricians are pulling hot wires and they're neutral wires, your hot wire can be any color except green or white. Your white wire is going to be your neutral wire. If you have four wires with a ground or four wires and no ground, we need to find which two wires are the line side and which two are the load side. When you look in your box, we can see that these two wires are coming in one side of the box and these two wires are a matched pair coming in from another side of the box. So now I'm using my tester, I'm pressing it onto the hot wire in the neutral and you can see it's 120 volts. When I touch these two, there's nothing. So I know that these two wires are coming in from the service panel, and now these are the two wires that I will connect to the line side of the GFCI. These two wires will be on the load side. Now that I know that these two wires are my line side, we're going to turn off the electric. For any project like this, always turn off the power to any circuit you're working on. A shock under the right conditions can be deadly. This GFCI has two different ways you can wire it. You can put a loop on your wire and wrap it clockwise under the screw and tighten it, or you can slide the wire straight under this plate and then tighten it down. And this is good if you have stranded wire to slide it underneath that plate. Once you've screwed your GFCI into the box, you can plug something in and test it. I'm going to press the test button. It should turn off. And then press the reset button and it should go back on.